Hey everybody, it's Cheryl and Tito lead Off Leash K9 Training, and we're going into his third session of place command. I showed you number one. We did another 10 minutes last night of pretty much what we did yesterday, and I'm going to show you what we do in the third session. And every dog is different. I'm not calling it place yet. I'm just showing him what I want him to do, which is to get on this cot and stay on it. So I'm adding a little bit more challenge by walking past, maybe dropping the leash. And again, every dog is going to be in a different place with this, so it's going to look different for your dog. So you need to pay attention to what they're doing, not necessarily what Tito's doing here. But we'll talk a little bit about this. We're going to go the same direction like we were yesterday in our first and second session. I'm going to walk him up here. That was a pretty bad start. Let me start again. I'm going to start with him on my right side, because when I go outside of it, he's been walking on the right side. So that takes a little bit of thought for me. We're going to walk up, slow him down. He looks at me, lean him on. Leave a little pressure to keep him there. Yes! And he's working for his breakfast. So he's being picky, so I'm going to add some higher value treats in there so he gets going with eating. Let's pick these up, get them out of the way, maybe he'll eat some while we're down here. Okay, let's try it here. And I'm going to turn this again because his body is so long. Walk him up. He looks at me. Lead him on. Yes! Oh. He knows. Let me get some more of the good ones. That's really what he wants to work for. So when you get a dog that doesn't really have a lot of food drive, or he's nervous or he's not eating so well, you gotta up the ante with higher value treats. As well, the e-collar comes in great, and so does leash pressure. It helps. You don't have to do a food lure. So we're gonna walk him over. Lead him on. Yes! And be excited when he comes off and feed him a treat. So he's kind of getting what I want. He's anticipating by walking on there. So that's why we slow him down, because I want everything to come from me. I want him to look at me. I'm going to lead him on. Yes! And I pause there, but I'm going to try to walk by now. I'm going to see what he knows. He might follow me, but he might not. Let's see. I'm going to use a little bit of the leash. Lead him on. Stop him there. Yes! Good boy, bud. Good boy. Do you notice how I had the leash taut, not taut, sorry, a little bit more choked up but still slack in it, right here? And then when I put him on that time, I dropped the leash so I could continue moving without giving him communication here. So I'm really careful with when I'm putting tension on this and when it's in free, non-tension mode. So we're bringing him on. Dropping it, he got distracted, which was awesome. It kind of helped. See what happens when he gets undistracted? Nope. the leash work back on. Yes! And he gave me a sit down, which was even better. So like I said, every dog's different. You gotta see where they are. I don't wanna call it placed yet. Michael Ellis, a really great trainer, says don't name it until you like it. So I'm not naming it. He doesn't really know what I want yet. He's looking at me, lead him on. Nope. Yes! Good boy, bud. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Lead him on. Drop some slack. To check out what was happening there with the leash. So he's starting to understand I want him to stay on here, so maybe I'll add some movement to this one. Lead him on, drop the leash. I'm moving really slow as I drop the leash. Add a little movement. Yes, good boy. Good boy, bud. Good boy, Tito. So watch when I drop the leash, you'll see me slow down just a little bit. He really is interested in what's outside. Lead him on. Drop. He's distracted, so I can drop the leash without worry on that one, to be honest. See what he does when he steps up, or when he looks up, see if he decides to step off, or if he realizes, yes! And he stayed. Good boy. Good boy, Tito. So not putting tension on the leash unless I want to, on purpose. Let's go. Like right there. Let's go. Good. Right there. Lead him on. Drop the leash. Nope. Good. The nope and a little bit of turn, physical, spatial pressure helped him. Yes. Good boy, bud. Good boy, Tito. So I'm going to do a little leash wiggle, which is another way to see if he's understanding what I want, which is for him to stay on. Do you see how I keep stopping him here? Because he just kind of is on autopilot a little bit in his own world. Good. Lead him on. Give the slack, but I didn't drop it all the way. Nope. A little spatial pressure. Good. I don't care if he walks around. Nope. I just don't want him to get off. Good. Yes. All right. Well, I didn't get two for that. Oh, get that one. So. Normally it would be his breakfast, but he wasn't into it. So he's going to, hey, let's go. A little pressure. He's going to work for treats right now. But once we get on e-collar and more voice command, he won't need anything anymore. Good boy. Lead him on, drop the slack. Good. Nope. Good. Yes! I like that when I said nope, he sat down, which I marked with a good. And then I gave him a release word of yes. Let's go. The least pressure, good boy. So like I said, each dog is different. I'm still going the same way with him. I'm dropping the leash, giving him a little slap when I move away, testing to see if he understands he needs to be on this cot and stay on until I tell him otherwise. Lead him on. Good. I'm using the marker for good. I'm going to walk around. Nope. Good. 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 Yes! Good boy, buddy. Good boy, Tito. So let's go the other direction. Let's see what happens when we go this way. You think it wouldn't change, but you never know, because the window's there now. There's more direction. I mean, sorry, more distraction. Let's go. So right there, did you see me pivot? That was helping him. Anything you can do to help your dog be successful, you should do it. Right there, I dropped the leash, which was a distraction, but then I pivoted and gave him a little pressure of my body, which helps him stay on there, versus just walking away like this. Good. I'm getting a little faster in my movement. Good. That's all testing him. Yes! Good boy, buddy. Good boy. One thing you need to be careful of when you drop the leash, if they're wearing a prong collar, is for them to step on it and then do a self-correction and give themselves some sort of communication that wasn't intended. Lead the dog on. Give some slack. I'm going to use the leash because sometimes that's directional, right? And I don't want him to get off. I want him to know when he gets on this thing, he needs to stay on it. He's watching my hand because it's confusing. Eventually place means get on and lie down. Yes! The fact that he sat down was awesome, so I wanted to mark that. And building upon what he's already learning and learned. Okay, a couple more, and then that's going to be it. We don't want to keep these sessions too long. Let's go. Let's do one more going from this side. Lead him on. I'm dropping the leash. Moving quite faster this time. He's staying there. Good boy. Smart guy. Yes! Good boy. Oh, right there he stepped on it, which I gotta be careful of that. So I'm gonna put him on a flat collar for the next session. But that's a check-in with him. It's the third session of place. And probably the next one, I will do a little bit of duration work, meaning I'll put him on, do this. And so he just looked at that because it touched him on the back. Test by sitting down, because this is often a cue. When I sit down, the dog wants to run over. Nope, just like that, a little pressure. Marked the movement, nope. Physical correction with my body. Good. And marking, this is where the markers come in. I'm marking the fact that he's not getting up when I sit down. Good. So we're gonna do more of that next time. And at some point here, we're gonna start to name it, but not quite yet, good. Now harder if I get on the ground, because that's even closer. Nope, you saw that, right? Dogs are so used to doing what they want when we get kind of near their space, good. Last test right here. Moving slowly on purpose. Nope. Good. Yes! Then you can come and eat it. Good boy, bud. So that's session number 3. Checking with him. Hope you guys are having a good day.